Kiel, sunken ships line the basin which was once the haven for a major part of the Reich Navy. A survey of this and other North German ports testifies to the accuracy of 8th Air Force and RAF bombings. Kiel has been the German naval headquarters through two world wars. In May 1945, its shipbuilding facilities are badly wrecked. The 10,000-ton Nazi pocket battleship Admiral Scheer capsized in the 11th April RAF raid on Kiel. She was built 12 years ago at a cost of 15 millions and mounted six 11-inch guns. Three U-boat assembly yards were blasted. About a dozen subs had been scuttled at Kiel. Despite its camouflage, the Admiral Hipper 10,000-ton cruiser was twice struck by bombs. One hit, abaft the control tower on the port side, penetrated several steel decks. The cruiser Emden also was knocked out. At Bremerhaven, the liner Europa is found in relatively good condition, although she'd been silted in. Recently, she was used as a German naval barracks. During the days when she was the pride of the Hamburg American line, the Europa was a contestant for the Blue Ribbon for speed on the North Atlantic run. The Allies consider her the most important prize found in the northern port. Copenhagen yields a small fleet of German midget submarines. These are the Molke type, a one-man ship 35 feet long. Normally, it's armed with two modified electric torpedoes, which can be replaced by one or two mines. The British report that the Nazis used masses of midget U-boats in an unsuccessful attempt to blockade southern England and disrupt supply lines. More normal and healthful living conditions are brought into the Belson concentration camp, where British troops found 60,000 dead, dying, and starving inmates. Today, special rations are provided for those who can't assimilate ordinary foods. Hospital accommodation for 17,000 patients has been organized. In 1 month, the death rate at Belson is reduced by 80%. The bodies of those who were too far gone to be saved are removed by Nazi prisoners under British guard. Distributing displaced persons' identity cards, initiating a systematic movement of the freed inmates to transit camps. Estimates of the total number of DPs in Germany vary from 4 to 7 million. More than 2 million have been settled in camps by the 12th Army Group, while the others are in the 6th and 21st Army Groups. On 21st May, in a ceremony attended by former prisoners, British Bren flamethrowers go into action and fire the huts where atrocities were perpetrated by the Nazis. For several days, areas of the camp have been gradually burned in an attempt to check the spread of disease. A report from London states that a monument is to be raised at the site of the Belson camp. Air Force films of a B-17 loading a new type rocket booster bomb. Jacked into position, the 18-foot bombs fit on special wing racks. General Doolittle's men call the bomb the Disney Swish. After the fins are put in place, the flying forts will take the bombs aloft for pre-VE Day strikes on German installations in Holland. Still in the experimental stage, the Disney Swish is used against special targets such as rocket sites, sub and E-boat pens, and similar objectives where penetration of concrete emplacements is necessary. At a given point after bombs away, the rocket propellant within the projectile is activated, leaving a trail of smoke as it drives the bomb down at increasing speed, plunging it 40 to 50 feet into the ground before explosion. The immediate target is a rectangular structure at the right center screen. Two hits are scored. Camouflaged pillboxes built by the Germans in the Dolomite mountain ranges, northern Italy. The forts blend in with the rugged terrain and command important military highways. a camouflage strong point constructed on the side of the mountain. Pillboxes have numerous gun positions and ports. The doors are built to form part of the main structure of the fortification and fit snugly when closed. Walls are made of wood and papier-mâché. Rock formation of the mountainside is cleverly imitated. A typical mountain chalet is converted into an armed fort. Gun positions in the chalet. Doors conceal the fort's firepower. An anti-tank ditch guarding the chalet. Another type of pillbox built into the mountainside. German capitulation in northern Italy prevented these defenses from being used against Allied troops. Pillboxes overlooking routes 48, 51, and 52 dominate these strategic arteries. This border area guarded the approaches to the Southern Reich. Navy films of the LCS L3, landing craft support, large, Mark III, a gunboat to support amphibious operations. Designed for rapid firepower, at the bow she mounts a 3-inch caliber 50 local control dual-purpose gun and a twin 40-millimeter AA gun. In addition, she carries light automatic weapons. Midships on the superstructure deck are 20-millimeter AA machine guns, both to port and starboard. Each 20 is fitted with a Mark 14 gyro sight to establish lead for the gunner. There are two more 20s on the main deck aft, and near the stern, the gunboat mounts another twin 40-millimeter. It may be aimed and fired by a Mark 51 director. A steel splinter shield provides ammunition storage. The LCS L3 also mounts the newest type rocket launchers. It employs 4.5-inch rockets in salvo fire. The Navy has this to say for the gunboat. Cubic foot for cubic foot, she's among the most heavily armed vessels in the fleet, a pint-sized floating gun platform. She cruises at 10.5 to 12 knots. 16 knots is her maximum speed. The boat is equipped with four pumps, which can be used for salvage operations, such as pumping out flooded compartments and as auxiliaries to the ship's firefighting system. The pumps can bring about 2,400 gallons of water into play. They utilize seawater supplied by suction lines dropped overside. In addition, each gunboat has fog applicators to make a screen, behind which she can approach and smother oil or gasoline fires. A Bessler generator on the stern converts a special type fog oil into protective smoke, which is useful in any screening operation. The gunboat demonstrates its firepower. Air Force films of 1,000-pound Azons used against the Japanese escape route from Rangoon, Burma. Late in April, B-24s of the 493rd Squadron, 7th Heavy Bombardment Group, strike rail and road objectives between Moh Main and Bangkok in Thailand. In this raid, the Azons are released at 8,000 feet. Following the bomb's trajectory by means of the million candle power flare attached to its tail, the bombardier steers the radio-directed missile toward the target. Two Azons, individually controlled, are guided in the direction of a bridge which would facilitate the Japanese withdrawal from Lower Burma. The approaches on either side of the span are pinpointed.